It's Friday morning, and we want to continue our thoughts in Psalm number 82. Remember, it's about the judges over a nation. And the psalmist is talking about corrupt judges who are supposed to be sitting in the place of God, making righteous judgments on his behalf, determining good and evil, right and wrong, just and unjust. And yet they are corrupting those things. We certainly have that as an epidemic in our country. We recognize there's no greater scourge upon a country than to have corrupt leadership, particularly corrupt judges. Nothing destroys a nation quicker than when the judges of that nation are perverting the justice system. Because of these corrupt judges, because of very greedy lawyers and uncouth lawyers, those who have no real integrity and twisting judgments, because of the liberal pandering, because of bullying on the part of the Democratic Party as we try to hold up the standards of righteousness, and they want to oppress and put down those standards, because of bribes that go on. All these things have corrupted the justice system. And when there's a perverted justice system, then bad things begin to happen in that nation. Now notice again in verse number 1, he says that God sits in the judgment where those people are making these judgments. He stands in the congregation of these mighty. And he says in verse number 2, how long are you going to judge unjustly? Are you going to continue on this? What you need to do, he says, is quit showing partiality to the wicked. Isn't it amazing? It just seems to be the natural humanistic desire is to see wickedness in a nation. Even among the leadership, they put down those who preach Christ. They belittle the Christian pastors. They talk about us as bigoted. They do everything they can to discredit us, and yet they hold up the wicked and make sure the wicked have everything their way. It is a terrible time in our nation, folks. It's a time when the justice system has been turned on its head. It's a time where there is no longer any real basis for judgment except that which the liberals have determined is right, and they're going to get their way. And it seems like they are getting their way in our nation right now. Now, maybe that will turn. We'll see. But he said we need to defend the poor and the fatherless. Simply because someone's rich enough to get the best lawyer who can twist judgment, who can use his influence to bully other people, he says, don't do that. Listen to the case. Defend the poor. Defend the fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and the needy. Then he says, free them from the hand of the wicked. Somebody needs to free us from the hand of the wicked today. Satan has a stronghold upon this nation. He has his people in key positions, and he is wringing out every injustice that he can possibly do that. Now, they're calling it social justice, that they're really trying to bring justice. The truth is they're oppressing the righteousness, and they're upholding the evil in our nation. This seems to be where we're at in America. And then notice in verse 5, he says, they do not know, nor do they understand. These folks have no real understanding of true righteousness. They've eaten off of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil and think that now they know what is good and what is evil. They have never looked to the Word of God. Or if they look to the Word of God, it says in verse number 5, they walk in darkness and all the foundations of the earth are unstable. Man, what a problem. Then he says, I said to you, this is now what God, this is a quote, I said to you, you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High, but you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. Ruth Bader Ginsburg, one of the greatest liberal judges, pushed every ungodly vice upon Americans that she could possibly push, very much pushed the immorality movement. She now has died, and she's going to stand before God in a day of judgment one of these days. Because you see, he will judge righteously. He is going to determine right from wrong. She got her way in this world. She pushed herself upon the American populace. And now she must give an account to Holy God. And that is true of all. We need to be warned by this. And that's what he's saying. You judges, you're going to die. and you're going to be judged. And verse number 8, he ends by saying this, "Arise, O God, judge the earth." Now listen, he says, "For you shall inherit the nations." Now who's he talking about there? Jesus. Because Jesus came to this world, he died for the sins of mankind, he rose again, and one day he's coming back, and he is going to inherit all the nations. There will be a one world government. He will sit as the ultimate judge over all things. And he will declare righteousness, and he will declare wickedness, and he will bring all things into perfect judgment. And we say, "Even so, Lord Jesus, come quickly." Aren't you looking forward to that day? Well, let's make sure we live a holy, righteous life today and serve the Lord as fully and faithfully as we can. Let's pray. Father, we thank you just for a few moments in the Word. Help us, Father, to always look to your Word, to find our balance, to find our rock to stand upon, to build our lives upon, to build our marriages upon, to build the church upon. And Father, we just know that now the foundations of our nation are so unstable. But Father, we pray that you'll bring these things back that we had once before in our nation, righteousness and justice and judgment. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.